didn't want to talk about this. It was somebody else's problem. It was too simple.
Oh, hi, Sierra.
Hi.
Oh, I'm sorry, darling. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to interrupt.
Mother, you're not interrupting. Tonio came by to pick up a suit.
Well, but I thought Lily was having supper with you here.
She did have supper with me. She went home to do her homework.
Oh.
Well, as long as I've got both of you here, there's something I'd like to ask you about.
What?
Well, Lily overheard you, Mother, talking to Tonio, and you said that you'd take care of Craig, that Tonio needn't worry about him. And so I was just wondering what you were talking about.
Your mother simply meant that given Craig's current difficulties, we shouldn't take advantage of the situation and raid his client list.
Ah, that's true. I said something like that.
Are you telling me the truth?
Oh, darling, come on. You know how I feel about Craig. It's a complex relationship, but I'm mad at him because he left my business, and I don't like that, but that's business. But the murder? You think I would want to see that young man rot in jail for murder?
Sierra, remember what happened last time you jumped to conclusions. There were many painful consequences because of that.
Yes, dear, there were. Now, we're giving it to you straight. We're telling you the truth.
All right, there's one way you could convince me of that. And that would be if you'd run the Craig Montgomery Associates ad, the one that ran the Argus and the City Times, free of charge.
All right, dear, I will.
You'll do it?
Yes, of course I'll do it for you.
Great. Well, then I'll get Lisa to bring the mechanical spy in the morning.
Oh, wonderful. I get a chance to see Lisa in the morning.
What if the briefcase doesn't tell them who killed Tad Shanny? Then we're back to square one again.
Negative thinking is off limits to you, darling.
I just wish there was some evidence that didn't point to Craig at this point.
Lila, there is no way a kid of yours could be capable of murder, so stop worrying. All you're going to do is get wrinkles.
I don't get wrinkles, I get bags.
Well, I don't know. You look pretty well preserved for an old lady.
You call it an old lady.
Atta girl. Now there's the old spunk. Get up there.
Well, now, how was the briefcase discovered?
McKechnie's dogs found it.
Oh, certainly a bizarre scene at the castle when I was...
Now, wait, I want to know, how was it that you got to tag along with the cops?
Well, I happened to be at police headquarters when McKechnie called in about the briefcase, and since there was a storm coming and I know all the island approaches, I offered to take Hal out there in my boat.
Now, what was so bizarre?
Well, for starters, when I got there, Barbara and Paul were there.
What? Barbara said she told me she had nothing to do with getting Duncan over here. You see, Shannon was right.
I think Shannon may also be right when she said that she thought there might be something illegal going on there and they're trying to cover it up.
Now, you said that Duncan called the police when he found out about the briefcase. Well, if he's up to anything out there, why would he have the police on the island?
Oh, I think he'd do that because he would want them there to prove that he had nothing to hide.
Goodness, you're getting to be a regular Nancy Drew, aren't you?
Better than Nancy Drew. And I am not going to rest until I see that Craig is out of jail and we get the murderer behind bars, whoever he or she may be. Good evening.
Amazing woman, huh?
Yeah. No, I'm worried about her. I see, she still has no idea that you've received those threats against her.
I spoke to Hal Munson about it. He assured me they have a plainclothes cop watching her 24 hours a day. If you stay close to her, I think that should take care of it. As a matter of fact, why don't you ask to spend the night at the penthouse?
I'm way ahead of you.
Hal, listen.
Hello,
I
Lisa.
Just heard about the briefcase that they found. Now, tell me, is there anything else I should know?
Lisa, because I can't talk about that. What? I need to speak to Brian. Brian, may I speak to you for a moment, private?
Sure. Excuse me, sir.
What's up, Hal? There's no easy way to break this to you, Brian, but I just received a phone call from the guy with the raspy voice at the station.
Ed?
He implied that he had Shannon. He said if the articles didn't stop immediately, you might not ever see her alive again. I've already got the Las Vegas police working on it, but at this moment, that's about all that we can do.
My God. I knew I should never have let her go out there alone.
Damn it, Cheney!
I took this gig because of the bread, not because I wanted to sit in a hot cave with these two crazy broads.
Look, calm down, Willie. The pay's still good, even without the casino winnings.
What pay?
Look, maybe the man will come up with more bucks. He said this was a big job.
What man?
Look, you're not running this show, baby, so shut your yap.
Look, I'm going to take a ride into town and give him a call, all right? Maybe he'll up the ante.
It'll be real convincing.
I don't know what's going on. I have a feeling.
So you two really lost all that loot at the blackjack table, huh?
Well, I every cent, I swear.
Well, since you two like gambling so much, I'm going to teach you a new game. Odds aren't too hot, but losing's going to be a hell of a lot more fun.
Meg right now. I told you it happened at dinner. Holden felt completely out of place. Dusty fit right in. Dusty and I are closer in age. We have a lot more in common that Holden and I wouldn't help him understand, you know? I mean, maybe my mother's right. We're from completely two different worlds.
Earth to Holden. I'm back. Thanks for the dance.
Don't say thanks. Maybe I'll catch you again later.
Okay. You know, when a guy stares into his drink all night and lets his date dance with somebody else, it usually means he's in love.
Didn't we go to different? Oh, yeah.
Yeah. It usually means something else, too.
What's that?
The guy's a loser.
I'm no loser, baby.
You could end up that way. You really want to spend the rest of your life on that fog?
I really don't know if there's anything else I can do.
Bull. Winners can do whatever they put their minds to.
Well, all I have is a high school diploma. Never been to college.
So what? You don't need a college education to get somewhere. Your ex-boss, Lucinda Walsh, has an empire there just for the taking.
Yeah, but she can't stand the sight of me.
It's only because your her precious daughter is the hot for you.
What are you talking about?
Do I have to draw you a picture?
Yeah, draw me a picture.
Make a deal with her. Tell her if she'll give you a break, you'll lay off her precious daughter. To interfere into your opportunity. Then if you're really clever, outsmart her. You can have Lily in your career too, if that's what you want. I want to dance. Game?
Yeah, let's dance. Cutie, how are you?
Exciting. Lily, what are you doing all alone in the dark? Are you all right?
Cut the act, Meg. My mother's not around to observe it.
Lily, if you're upset about being over at Dusty's, he didn't know anything about it. I just dropped over. I promise.
Yeah, I'm sure of that.
If you don't believe me, why don't you just call him and ask?
I am so surprised you didn't seduce him into spending the whole evening there.
I wouldn't do that.
What about New Mexico?
New Mexico was different. We both wanted it. We were very in tune with one another.
Spare me the gory details, Meg, please.
Lily, you know, you'd probably feel a lot better if you were just honest with yourself. I can tell that Holden turns you on. How long do you think he's gonna wait around till you grow up?
Let's get one thing straight, Meg. There's a lot of differences between you and me, but there's one big one. I don't use sex to get what I want. I want a deep, lasting relationship where making love is just a natural part of it. Dusty and I came very, very close. But he respects me too much. Maybe that's why you're not over at the penthouse right now. Maybe after all that's happened, he's lost all respect for you.
Maybe the reason you and Dusty never did it was because you weren't woman enough. Did you ever think of that?
She's a blackmailer, that's what she... Here, darling, I brought that for you, you know.
Oh, thank you.
Oh. Mmm. Sierra, dear, when Lily was here, did she mention and talk to you about Holden Snyder?
Yeah, she did. She's still a little upset with you for the way you treated him at dinner. And frankly, Mother, I can't blame her.
Well, he's not good enough for her. He's just not. Somehow I must convince her of it.
Don't you understand? The harder you try to push her away from him, the more she's going to want to be with him. And besides, I don't see what's so wrong with Holden. I mean, he's a nice guy.
No, honey, he's only in it for the money. He's just like all the other greeting members of his family.
I think that the Snyders are nice. Do you want some advice from me?
Yes, I do.
I'm serious.
I really do.
I don't think you should interfere with Holden and Lily. Not the way you did with me and Craig. Because she's not nearly as forgiving.
Oh, honey. Oh, honey, but we don't want her to wind up with some kind of fortune hunter, do we?
You sound like some Victorian novel.
Well,
would you mind
am.
Getting that? I'm going to pick up a little bit.
Please. Yes, miss. Hey, Dusty.
Hi.
Hi. Nice to see you. Oh, you're getting lonely upstairs with John away in London.
Oh, speaking of John, I have a message for you. John said to tell you he took Lily's medical records with him. If she needs some kind of medical treatment, you can call him. He said you'd understand that.
Well, shucks, he's right. I do understand that. I do. You just tell John the next time you talk to him that I got the message, all right?
Okay.
Darling! I'm gonna go now.
Good night.
Bye-bye.
Bye,
good to see you, Dustin.
Good to see you, too. Bye.
Thank you. Yeah, Nick, what's up?
Just got the lab report on that lipstick Seth Snyder turned in earlier. Matches the lipstick from the mirror, exactly.
Terrific. Good work, Nick. Listen, have somebody send it over to the Mona Lisa right away, okay?
I'll bring it myself.
No, I want you to stay there in case the Las Vegas Police Department calls.
Hey, how did McCall take the news?
About like any guy who just heard that his fiancée had been kidnapped.
Game strip blackjack, remember?
I'm allowed to decide what it is that I take off. Those are the rules.
Good thing you ain't got no more jewelry left. Now we can get down to the nitty-gritty.
Tell me, is a man named Duncan McKechnie behind all this?
I don't know no names. All I know is some guy from Illinois.
I am sure this is Duncan. I should never have let him drive me to the airport. I'm sure he saw exactly where I was going.
I would feel a whole lot better about
it. Would you two quit gabbing? Play cards?
Listen, I'm sure when your friend comes back, you're going to realize this is all a terrible mistake. We have no money to give you.
You lose. Now take it all.
Okay, okay.
Great.
Okay, stand back.
Oh, good.
Okay, now, yeah, don't follow us.
Stay. Stay.
Where do you think you two are going?
Thank God I just remembered the Argus is going to press with my expose on the Falcon. I've got to stop it.
Earl Hellbunzel wants to talk to you.
Hey, Brian, come on now. Tell me, what is
I can't talk about it.
You've got to tell me what's going on. Brian!
Bobby?
Oh, great. Okay. Thanks, Walker.
Come on, Lila. Keep your chin up. It's all going to work out for Craig. Trust me. I tell you what, I'm going to go home. I'm going to whip up some linguine, uncork a bottle of wine, and when you get home with the good news, I'll help you celebrate it, right?
Yeah. Well, I think you may want to cancel the linguine.
Huh?
What a surprise. It's so good to see you.
Oh, it's nice to see you. Thanks. Thank you. I'm a little jet laggy, but
you'll be fine.
Hey, what are you doing here?
Hey, well, I'll tell you all about it. I just have to find Seth first.
Oh, he's not here tonight. I gave him the night off, darling. Well, he had a hectic day today with the fashion show.
Oh, well, I have a letter from Mrs. Snyder from John Dixon.
Why, did you see old Dr. D?
Oh, well, no, he just dropped it off at Aunt Penny's.
Oh, how is everything? How is Penny? How is Nancy doing with
it? Oh, she's great. We had a wonderful time, and her ankle is totally healed.
So tell me, what happened? How'd the interview go with Dr. Hildebrand?
Oh, it went pretty well. He agreed to put me in a seminar, and I go back in October.
Well, this calls for a celebration,
huh? Yeah,
it's
pretty nice, huh?
I think so.
Come on, let's go get a table, will you?
Okay.
I'll be right over. Jimmy?
I'll see you later.
Sure, Jimmy, bring us the best bottle of champagne in the house, okay? Thank you.
Good evening, Mrs. McCall.
I tell you, hi. You here all alone?
Yes, would you have a table available for me?
Indeed, I would. Hold on just a minute.
Thank you.
Here we go. How is this table? Right?
That would be fine.
All right, the waiter will be with you soon.
Thank you.
Lila, have you heard any more from Margot about this Channing case?
I learned a long time ago not to pry into Margot's cases.
I thought they realized that the person who was threatening Denise must be the same one who is the murderer. That's proof they should just release Craig.
Lisa, I am on your side, believe me. But there's still all that evidence in Craig's apartment.
Who else do you know of might have had a key?
Well, I don't... Well, there is one person, yeah. She just walked in.
Lucinda?
Yeah, I found her in Craig's apartment. It was last fall. It was the night all the trouble began for Sierra and Craig.
Do you see? That all fits because she wrote that nasty article about Craig. I would bet you anything in the world that that woman is the one who put the lipstick.
Excuse me. Lila, I'd like to speak to you about this lipstick that was turned into us tonight.
Hi.
Hi.
I don't mean to interrupt, but I just wanted you to know I was here.
Well, I'm glad. I'll be with you in a minute, okay?
Denise, I heard you were really wonderful today.
Oh, thank you. Oh, and thanks for letting me use your dressing room.
It's all right. Anytime.
Okay.
See you. Does this belong to you?
No. Allura Cosmetics? It's way out of my price range.
You ever seen it in your dressing room?
No, I never have.
How could you ask her that?
One of your employees found it in your dressing room after the fashion show. Turns out to be the lipstick that was used to write the warning on that mirror.
That's impossible, because Earl and I cleaned up that dressing room, and no one else was in there except Seth Snyder. Is he the one that turned it into you?
Yeah. Lila, would you mind taking me to your dressing room? I'd like to look around.
No, not at all.
Thank you.
Excuse me.
Tom, it's me. I've got to speak to Margot, please. No, I don't want you to wake her up. Look, tell her to call me first thing in the morning, would you? All right, look, Tom, I think I know who threatened Denise and killed Tad Channing.
This portion of As the World Turns has been brought to you today by Antiseptic Scope with T25. Scope leaves your breath minty fresh, not medicine-y. And by Dawn, the dishwashing liquid that takes the grease out of your way. We'll continue with part two of As the World Turns in just a moment. As the World Turns.
I told you you were a terrific dancer if you just forget your inhibitions.
Oh, thanks.
You shouldn't put yourself down. I learned at an early age, there's lots of people who will do it for you.
You seem to be on a real high tonight. What's going on?
And why shouldn't I be? That trust fund I inherit on my birthday means total freedom for my mother. I never have to ask her for another thing again.
I'm here to collect on that dance you promised.
I didn't actually promise. You mind?
Go ahead.
Good.
Okay.
Make a deal with her. Make her give you a break in exchange for staying away from her precious daughter.
You'll never be anything but a stable boy. My daughter's off limits. Understand? Off limits.
If you're smart, you can have both.
So Fiona sounded really strange on the phone, and I felt it didn't make any sense that she would just ask for her vacation out of nowhere.
Yeah, but how did you find out that she'd been arrested?
Well, I called the police station.
I can't believe it.
Yeah, I can't believe it either. I don't know how John's going to react when he comes home and we have no housekeeper.
Well, why don't you call an employment agency?
Well, I was going to do that, but by coincidence, I got a letter from a friend of mine in New Mexico. And apparently, the lady who used to cook for all of us when I was out there on the ranch gave her week's notice, and she's going to Chicago. So I'm going to look into that.
Well, that's a good idea.
I think it's a good idea. Anyway, the real reason I came here was to talk about Lily a little bit.
Yeah, well, I guessed as much.
Sierra, the last time I went to your mother's house, Holden was there. I don't know if you know this, Holden and Lily became very close this summer.
Well, yeah, I noticed. You're running away kind of. Help that along.
Well, that was the worst mistake I ever made in my life. I don't know how much he told you about what went on out there.
Enough to know that some mistakes were made. But, Dusty, you're young. I mean, anything that happened in New Mexico is not going to destroy your life.
I wish I could believe that.
I think you should just tell her that you made a big mistake and that you regret it.
Yeah. See, there's a dance at my school next week, and I'm starting out there fresh and everything. You think I should ask Lily?
Oh, yes, call her. And when you call her, explain to her what Meg was doing upstairs tonight. I mean, she saw that.
She
didn't...
She was up there?
Well, yeah, didn't Meg tell you?
I can't believe it. No, once again, she conveniently left that point out.
The big difference between you and me is I don't believe in using sex to get what I want. I want a deep and lasting relationship where making love is just a natural part of it.
Happy 10th anniversary, darling.
You haven't told me if you like your present yet.
Oh, I can't believe the Walsh Mansion is all ours now, all the antiques and things. Even old Matthew. Too bad Lucinda had to move to be closer to Lily.
Oh, poor Lily locked up in an institution. I just wish she could have lived a fuller life.
Oh, Lucinda called today. Lily's still in therapy, but she's just not ready to face life outside those walls.
That is too bad.
Yeah, especially because I owe her so much. She made me realize that what I really wanted out of life was a deep and lasting relationship with you.
Dad!
How's my little man? My little girl? My little Lucinda?
Wasn't that wonderful of your godmother to send us those savings bonds? It was a stroke of genius to name her after Mrs. Walsh.
Mm.
Well, now, you, and you, sir, time for you to wash up for dinner. And then afterwards, when you're all ready, we'll open our presents, okay?
Yay!
Oh, Dusty Jr. looks more like you every day.
Yes, he does, doesn't he?
I was always afraid that, well,
He might be a reminder of why we got married.
Meg, I am so thankful that you were so clear about things years ago. You made me grow up overnight. I can honestly say that in 10 years of marriage, I haven't a single regret.
No. Oh!
Holden, what a nice surprise.
Just wanted to wish you all a happy anniversary. Boy, I remember this place so well. How much has changed. Never thought I'd be married to Janie and have 7 kids. Oh, well. Thank you for the tractor, by the way.
Oh, no problem, Holden. Don't mention it.
Dusty, darling, would you go see after the children? I'd like to speak to Holden alone for a minute.
Of course.
Oh, Holden, I feel so bad for you. I wish things had worked out for you and Lily.
Oh, well, that's life, Maggie.
You know, if you hadn't gone back on your bargain all those years ago, you and Lily could have a deep and lasting relationship, too.
Don't remind me. Have you heard from her?
She's no better, poor thing. She's just as confused at 27 as she was at 17.
Walsh Residence.
Hello, Meg. It's Dustin.
Hi, Dusty. I was just thinking about you. I'm glad you were thinking about me, too.
Actually, I'd like to speak to Lily, please. Is she there?
I'm sorry to disturb you, Miss Lily, but Miss Snyder said it was important.
What is it, Meg?
Dusty wants to speak to you.
Well, in that case, I'll take it upstairs.
Don't bother. I was just leaving.
Oh, good. Thank you. Get out of my house. My house. Dusty!
Hi. I heard you stopped by the penthouse.
Did Meg tell you?
No, Sierra did.
Meg didn't tell you? What a surprise.
Lily, she just stopped by. I knew nothing about it.
She told me.
She did?
It's a miracle, huh? For once in my life, she's being honest.
How's your foot?
It's better. I'm supposed to get the stitches out tomorrow, hopefully.
Are you coming to the hospital?
Yeah, my appointment's at 8:30.
Lily, that's great. I'm going to be there tomorrow morning. We can have something to eat in the cafeteria.
Yeah, we'll see how it goes, okay?
So how come you stopped by?
Well, I wanted to talk to you. I was confused. I guess it was, force of habit to come running to you, I guess.
I'm sorry I wasn't there. I went for a run.
It's okay. It's no big deal.
The reason I called is I'd like to invite you to the freshman dance next week.
That's very sweet of you, but I don't know if I'll be up for dancing next week. Why don't you take somebody else?
Lily, no way. I'm not going to go if you don't go with me. Come on. Please.
Okay. All right, fine. I'll go with you.
You certainly have a way of popping in and out of a guy's life. Just when I think you're going to be back for a while, it's back to old England in October.
No. But this is all very exciting for me. I finally have a sense of purpose, you know?
Well, I'm very happy for you. It's just that it's tough, you know? I'd like to see more of you.
I'm sorry. But you know how important this seminar is to me. Anyway, I'll be back before you know it.
Well, in the meantime, is there any room in your life for a crazy guy like me?
Okay,
all right. I'll back off. But what's the deal with Seth? I mean, do I have an equal shot here or what?
I'm not making promises to anybody right now.
I'll tell you one thing. Sure was good to see you walk into the Mona Lisa tonight.
You have no idea what it meant to me.
Why's that?
Well, it was just about a year ago that I walked in there and
met Doug Cummings for the first time.
I didn't know. You're handling it very well.
Yeah, I'm all right. I'm all right. All the unhappy memories are gone. And I just remember the things that I loved about
him. That's good. But don't make a martyr out of the guy. I mean, hey, Seth Snyder's hard enough to compete with.
Yeah, well. Sounds like your godson's hungry.
Oh, boy, I'm going to have to speak to that Benny Boombatz about his lousy timing.
Yeah, got it. Thanks a lot. That was the Vegas PD. Look, they got a guy stationed outside of Shannon's apartment. There was no signs of a struggle, and their clothes are still there. So maybe this is just some kind of a scare tactic.
I hope so. I'm not printing another word about the Falcon until I know Shannon is safe. Damn it. I should have listened to Earl. Called off my dogs a hell of a lot earlier than this.
Well, at least you don't have to worry about your stepmother. We still got that plainclothes guy out at her house.
No problem. She's with someone tonight.
No, Tonio. I do have a problem. Maybe you could help me with it. You can help me solve it. About my lily, my water lily.
What is your problem
my
with
problem
Lily?
My problem is that she's obsessed. She's infatuated with Holden Snyder and that awful boy. Oh, he'd certainly capitalize on that if he knew it. He probably does know it.
Well, if you want my opinion...
Yeah.
Offer him a job, something he can't resist.
Hmm.
I mean, he's hungry. Look at the way he jumped at the chance to work for Ted Channing.
Something he can't resist, because I've certainly offered him jobs, and he has been extremely rude to
me. No, listen to me, Lucinda. I know I'm
right. All right. I'll think about it. I think... Good. Now, handsome son-in-law, what do you want?
I only want Sierra.
Lisa, I wish I could explain, but I can't. I have to make
Dad?
A call.
Earl, please come back. Don't shut me out like this. Oh.
Where'd Mr. Mitchell go?
Mrs. Walsh wants him to join her.
Oh, don't worry about Lucy. I'll take care of it. Listen, dear, I'm afraid that Earl has plans for the evening. He won't be able to join you.
Oh, well... I'll just wait until he tells me himself.
No need to. I just told him.
What's the matter with you?
Hmm?
Are you upset because I introduced Barbara at the fashion show this morning?
Don't be silly. I was so happy to be relieved of such a trite little chore.
Good.
Yes.
This,
there he is, the man himself.
Yes.
I just wanted to talk a little business with you. Why don't you sit down and join us?
I just told you this man has plans for this evening. Why don't you talk tomorrow when, regular business hours?
Well, I'm tied up all day tomorrow, but there's no reason that Lucinda and I can't talk now. Lisa, we'll talk. We'll talk.
Thank you. Thank you.
Jimmy, would you please close up for me tonight, okay?
Sure, but I've already ordered dinner for two to be sent up to Mr. Mitchell's penthouse, like you said.
Cancel it. I'm going home.
Lisa! You are behaving like a spoiled child.
No,
I gotta make a phone call.
Hurry back. I want to dance with you. Compliments of the gentleman at the bar.
Oh, yeah? Which one is heading over here right now?
What are you doing here?
Like you. Well, I thought I'd better wait until your escort left before I came over to greet you properly.
This'll be just what Illinois needs for proof we've got him. I told you this was a good job. Man up the ante to $5,000 a head. If. When he gives the word, we don't let them walk out of here alive.
Let go of me!
Listen, I will get rid of Lucinda, and then we go play in the penthouse.
No. I've got an idea. You go play with Lucy in the penthouse, and you can drink champagne out of her slipper. Size 10 and a half, you know.
Lisa,